And we'll start from the bottom up. Last but definitely not least, Matthew Lappin on 68 votes. It's the top 10. Adrian Hickmott on 80 votes. Well under Hickey. Justin Murphy, 8th in the best and fairest count on 81 votes. Scott Caparelli, he's won it before. He's had another good season, 96 votes. The Rats, the man who wears number 7 so proudly, 96 votes. Lance Whitnell on 140 votes. We're going to the top four now. Simon Beaumont. Well done to Simon Beaumont, ladies and gentlemen. Fourth in the best and fairest. Well done, Bowie. 141. We'll be down at Jaffel Pies tomorrow, mate, in Port Melbourne. As we move on to third, Craig Bradley, ladies and gentlemen, is in third place. What a season for Braddles. We're down to the top two. Well done, Braddles. The top two. Andrew McKay with 166. Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the Robert Reynolds Trophy for 2002 is Corey McKernan. It's his first year at the Carlton Football Club. He's come across from the Kangaroos. He's the best and fairest winner. And John, you want to say a few words?
Yep.
I'd like to invite up onto stage 5-time best and fairest winner. And runner-up 4 times. Best first-year player too, John, in 1957. The Big Nick, John Nichols, to make the presentation of the best and fairest. And as Corey makes his way up and gets congratulated by his teammates and officials, let's take a look at some of the great highlights that he's given us in 2002. Corey McKernan, ladies and gentlemen.
Can he kick Carlton's first goal? McKernan from 48 metres. Great kick. He has drilled it. It's a great start.
Back across the ball,
right behind McKernan, kicking the puck road in, and Corey buries the goal. Blues by 7. This is Murphy, pressure from behind.
Wins this one, another points win. You won't make the distance, massive pack fly. That's a bad McKernan! He got a tower! Lucky he went size 15.
Size 50 on Bradley. Clever attack for McKernan! Goal for Carlton, they're not done it yet, the Blues.
He saves a fair ball, McKernan. Strong hands. Encouraging for Carlton. Comes on. Gets the zombie two. The stepping's on as well. McKernan, big throw, decides to have a go and go all the way. And go all the way he can from 55. He comes along to the goals, it'll be Clyde, it's a goal! Corey McKernan comes himself in glory again for Carlton.
He's certainly entertained us, no doubt about it. Runner-up in a best and fairest at the North Melbourne Football Club. He's won the top award, the big one, the Robert Reynolds Trophy, the best and fairest of the Carlton Football Club. I'd also like to invite up on the stage from DeMovo a very special guest here in Robert Schwartz. I'd like him to join us up on stage, of course, as the managing director of DeMovo. I'd like Robert to come up on stage. Thank you, Robert. And I'd like to say a few words. Well, I would like to welcome, to say a few words, the man who won 5 best and fairest, 4 times a runner-up in the best and fairest here at the Carlton Football Club, the big neck, John Nicholls, to say a few words about the 2002 winner, Corey McKernan. John.
Thank you, Jim. Ladies and gentlemen, and Carlton people, one and all, certainly our great club has had a great history and a great culture, and best and fairest nights are one of our most important nights of the year. I think there's probably only one other more important, and that's when we celebrate a premiership, which is not far away again. Look, to me, there's several things about Corey. Number one, he towers over me, and I wonder how he wasn't become one of the best ruckmen of all time. He's got, I think, something that I was very pleased when I knew Corey McKernan was coming to Carlton. I was also pleased when he wore number 2. We've had some very good players at Carlton with number 2. A couple of duds. But when Corey was coming, I knew that whilst he may be 28, he's played 200 games. He's still really, in my opinion, just really scratching the surface what his potential is. Consistency is really what wins best and fairest. The match committee who vote on it, and I believe our system is very good and very fair. It values players who contribute regularly, week in, week out, and that normally is what wins best and fairest. And Corey, I think I saw him play the first game against St Kilda, and mind you, he had a lot of mates that night. We were shocking. We played very poorly. Corey wasn't fit. He had recovering from an injury. But look, after those few weeks transition to a new club, a new coach, new teammates, I think it's a wonderful effort to win the Robert Reynolds Trophy, because he's been something that I believe has been a good player this year, but I cannot wait until he's fit and he's probably got five or six wonderful years left in him, and I think that now he's used to our culture. I just think he'll be a greater player next year, whether it be in the forward line or in the or rucking. And I think that I believe his best is still ahead of him. And to Corey McKernan. All right, Corey, come up, please. I'll just get a box to stand on, if you don't mind. Corey, it gives me great pleasure to present this best and fairest to you. It's something that I treasured. The club regards their best and fairest winners, I believe, rightly so, that it's something that premierships are not won by players who play one good game every 4 or 5 weeks. Premierships are won by players who play well nearly every week, and to win these, you've certainly deserved them, and I wish you congratulations for this year. And I'm really putting the pressure on you, because I think next year it's got to be one of your best ever years. So congratulations and good luck next year.
I think it'd be fair to say, mate, you're popular. After your first season here at Carlton, you must be thrilled with this, your best and fairest. Congratulations.
Yeah, I suppose at the moment you could really, I don't know what to say. After probably round 6 or 7 this year, and if you had said I would have been standing up here and I was going to win the best and fairest, people would have laughed at you. But I suppose with some of the injuries that we had to key players and things like that, I don't know, my whole thrust to my football year was to enjoy my football, get back to enjoying it, through the help of all the match committee. They all backed me through my hard times. I don't know what to say.
Well, why in Britain and in the coaching staff stuck by you? I mean, what, just in those early rounds, especially after round 7, the pressure, you're under the pump well and truly. You needed support, and Wayne and the coaching staff showed you that support.
Yeah, I know at the time, I don't know, you might even see some ISO footage on Channel 9, but I'm even standing there in the rooms after the game, sort of talking to Dad, and I suppose like most of the guys do. And I just looked at Dad and said, "Look, I'd been booed all game, copped it." And I just said to him, "I said, look, if this what it means, like I put so much into it, I don't really want to go through it again, like, but." Thankfully, I just managed it. I thought, nah, that's not for me. That's not Corey McKernan. And it doesn't matter what situation I'll get into. I'll persist and I'll work hard and I'll fight at it and stick it through. I sound like a blubbering mess at the moment.
You're doing well. You're doing well. John Nicholls has given you a huge rap, saying the best is still yet to come. You must be looking forward to next year.
I definitely am. I know with the way that I finished off in the second half of the year, and I actually felt like going out to play. I felt like 5 or 6 years ago. So with the guys that like we'll get back next year, like Curter and all these sorts of guys, it's going to be pretty exciting.
I'm sure you want to thank a few people, so I'll leave you with the microphone and go for it. Ladies and gentlemen, our best and fairest winner, Corey McKernan.
Yeah, I suppose, as I said, probably after round six or seven was a pretty dark time for myself. But it was through the support of my teammates. I've only been there a short period, but the support I get off even guys like Braddock's during the game, just coming up, say, keep going. Just the whole support I received off everyone. And last and not least, my girlfriend Robin. I know her and I, like, especially on the drive home from the MCG, and I was pretty distraught in the car, and no, she just said, don't worry about it and come home, and it's something I'll always be thankful of. But I sound terrible tonight. Really, I've won grand finals and things like that, and to go through, I went through what at the start of the year, and I know some of the people that are chanting my name now, and that's fantastic, but also some of the people that were jeering and things like that. So that's why, like, coming back and winning the award like this, I'm just stoked beyond belief. So.
I know it's hard to single out people, but major influences on your first season at Carlton. I don't want to miss someone out here, but I mean, there's so many great influences for you. Is there anyone in particular you'd like to make special mention of at the club?
Yes, especially in my case. I know at the time, like, he was copping it a fair bit, and that continued throughout the season. But I'll never forget for the rest of my life the way Brett stuck his neck out. It was something I'll always remember. And like, we were walking off the ground one day, and I remember him saying to me, he said, like, with the expectations of Carlton supporters and whatnot, and he goes, look, you could have came here unless you didn't play like Curtis. He goes, they're always going to be bagging you. So, like, just having little, like, chats like that, and, like, just for his support, I really can't thank him enough.
Well done. And we'll hear from Wayne Britton very, very shortly. I'm sure you want to say some words about Corey. Well done, mate. Congratulations. Your first best and fairest of the Carlton Football Club in your first year. Congratulations, ladies and gentlemen, the Robert Reynolds Trophy winner for 2002, Corey McKernan. Stay up on stage, mate. Corey, just stay up on stage, mate. Just one more presentation to be made. And it gives me great pleasure, our good friends at DeMovo, who are, of course, our naming rights sponsor for the Best and Fairest Count for 2002. It's great having them on board, and they're a terrific company, and it gives me great pleasure to introduce the Managing Director, Robert Schwartz, to say a few words and also to make another special presentation to our Best and Fairest winner. Robert.
Corey... Congratulations on a fantastic year, and I think out of a year of adversity comes something great. And I think Corey's effort throughout the year has been a shining light for the Carlton Football Club, so congratulations on that. Well done. Great effort to win the Robert Reynolds Trophy in your first year at the club. I'd also like to take the opportunity to thank the Carlton Football Club tonight for DeMovo to be able to sponsor such a prestigious event. It's been a great night. You know, we're very proud of DeMovo to have had an association with the club in 2002, and we're really looking forward to bigger and better things in 2003. So again, Corey, congratulations.
Ladies and gentlemen, our thanks to Robert Schwartz, also to John Nichols, who made the special presentation, and also to our best and fairest winner for season 2002. Another huge round of applause for Corey McKernan. I'd now like to call on the senior coach of the 2002 Carlton side to say a few words. Would you please put your hands together for Wayne Britton?